WordPress featured image. This is what we are going to learn in our next tutorial. So stay tuned. Hello and welcome to a new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial, we are going to know about WordPress featured image. Now, if we have a closer look into our previously built project, we can see that this is what we mean to. There should be an image thumbnail on some certain posts. And on clicking into these posts, we can see this is the full length content preview, and we can see that the image will be seen. In this particular case, we have used featured image as a background, but we can use it as an image source too. Now, if we get back to the admin dashboard panel of our current project, and if we head back to any of these posts, this is the all posts option, and if we click on any of these posts, for say this is the first post of our site, and in this extreme right panel, we can see that there isn't practically any kind of featured image option. But if we now head down to this appearance section, get back to themes, and if we activate any of these individual themes, for say I am activating this 2017 theme. Now, if we head back to posts again, and if we click any of these individual posts, in this extreme right panel, we can see that there is a featured image option which allows developer to use a particular image in order to represent that particular post. So this is what we need to activate to in our theme that we have created so far. So let's head back to this appearance themes and let's activate the present theme that we are working on. So our new theme is now activated. Head back to these posts, click any one of these posts, and you can see that there's practically no featured image option available into our theme. This is what we are about to activate in next. In doing so, the very first thing that we are going to do, let's get back to text editor and into this functions.php. Now, in the next case, in order to support featured image in our project, the first thing that we are going to do, all we need to do, we need to invoke this individual WordPress function, add theme support, and here, in order to support the featured image, all we need to do, we need to mention that thing right over here, which is known as post thumbnail. Now, this is the individual WordPress function which is used to support featured image option into our WordPress site, but unfortunately this is not the only one that needs to be put right over here. We need to precisely define when this individual WordPress function is about to come into play. So in order to do that, all we need to do, just cut it first, and in the first place we are defining here new function where we will be using this individual WordPress function, and in an order to let WordPress know when this WordPress function of add theme support should come into play, all we need to do, we need to define the precise moment of it. We are defining it through the add action option, and here we are defining that after set up the theme, this is the hook here, after set up theme, and we are defining that after setting up the entire theme, this individual WordPress function which enables featured image into our project, it should be coming into play. So this here goes the first parameter, and as the second parameter, we need to mention here the custom function that we had created in order to do that. So here it goes. we have made this complete thing right over here. This is not post thumbnail, this is post thumbnails. So once again, let's get back to our project and reload. And now we can see that in this extreme right panel, there goes the featured image option that we have created. So after doing all these things right over here, we have practically defined a new function, a custom defined function that will be enabling the WordPress featured image into our project. And we had defined that precisely after setting up the theme, this individual WordPress function of enabling the featured image should be coming into play. And this is the hook that we had defined right over here. And after defining it, we are using this image setup process. This is the custom defined function that we had created previously. So that is why we can see that this is the featured image which is now coming right into action into this extreme right panel. And if we now set our featured image, this is the option here. If we now upload one individual image, for say we are uploading this one right over here, so filling up all those things, if we now press this set featured image option here, we can see that the featured image is now enabled for this individual post. But if we still update this post, and if we get to the front end part, this is the front end part here, and if we reload, still we can see that there isn't any featured image which is enabled into our project. This is due to the fact we have registered the featured image property into our functions.php, but we haven't administered it anywhere into our project. And this is what we are going to do next. Now we need to administer this featured image into the pages precisely where we need it. So in the first place, all we are going to do, we are getting back to this content.php. This is the page which is practically controlling the front end of this individual site. So we need to administer, we need to display the featured image in this place in the first case. And if we head into each individual post, we need to invoke it into the part where actually all those individual posts are going to be played. So where do we need it? In the first place, we need to display the featured image into the content.php. So there it goes. We need to display those individual featured images into this particular page where all of these posts are being shown. And on the contrary, in the second case, we need to display it into this single.php here. So in the first place, let's head back to this content.php, and here we will be defining we are putting this WordPress function into the position where we need to display that featured image property into our project, and this is the content.php. In the first place, all we are going to do, we are just removing all the parameters. We don't need anything inside, and we are leaving this thing empty. Just get back to your project, reload, and we can see that for the first post, here goes the first post. We have activated, we have enabled this featured image property for the first post, and that is what we are going to see here. It is now enabled here into the front page of our page. But as we can see that this image is using the original dimension of the image to be displayed into our front page, all we need to do, we need to make usage of a thumbnail view. It should be a 100 pixels by 100 pixels thumbnail view that should be displayed into the front page of our site. So this is what we need to rectify next. We need to register some sizes such that those registered sizes are being displayed right into the pages wherever we wish it, into that defined size. So this is the next thing that we are going to do, to register some defined size of the images. But before that, we need to activate this image we need to display the image into the pages where we wish to appear them. So that is why we are copying this thing, getting back to this single.php, and here we are pasting it again. So in the second case, if we click into this individual post, we can see that the same image is now activated right over here. So the next thing that we are going to do, we are going to register some size, some defined size of these images, which we want to appear into these two individual pages.